Makes no sense in translation. Okay, that's another meta joke. Got it. Hey, PJs, what's up? Good to see you. Modding Cyberpunk. Trying to get back into it now that you finished Netrunner. Very good. I've been seeing a lot of friends play Cyberpunk, so it's good to see that a lot, that it's definitely more than just a few people. How are you modding it? Or what mods are you applying, I should say. Okay, Nexus Mod Collections. Welcome to Night City Collection, since they have Discord. That's fair. If they have a supporting, if you will, staff for it. Yeah. I know what you meant by Discord. By staff, I just typically mean a small crew. One guy is about right. People that can test it and all that kind of thing. Give feedback. Mm-hmm. Time to do some reading with you, Oreem. Wait. No. So I had one major issue, and it was actually a game-breaking thing for me. And it's a good thing that you actually had very few issues. In the very first mission with Jackie, the game just stopped working for me, and I could not progress at all. And I was very angry with that. Because I was just walking around for an hour going, I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. Nothing's happening. I'm in a room, and I can't do anything. But I did enjoy Cyberpunk a lot when I played it. It definitely had its faults, but I enjoyed it quite a bit. Ghost Under the Light, Part 2. The tendrils of my hair illuminate beneath the amber glow. The tendrils of my hair illuminate the amber glow, bathing. In the distance, a blue-green light flickers. A lone figure crosses its path, a silhouette obstructing the eerie glow. My heart pounds. The silhouette grows closer. Closer. I open my umbrella, casting a shadow to shield me from visibility. But I am too late. He steps into the streetlight. I gasp and drop my umbrella. The light flickers. My heart pounds. He raises his arm. Time stops. The only indication of movement is the amber light flickering against his outstretched arm. The flickering light is in rhythm with the pounding of my heart, teasing me for succumbing to this forbidden emotion. Have you ever heard of a ghost feeling warmth before? Giving up on understanding, I laugh. Understanding is overrated. I touch his hand. The flickering stops. The ghosts are blue-green. My heart is amber. Thank you. Hey, duty buddy, I see you there. I'll try not to kick you because you're right in my footpath. There we go. We'll show it to Sayori. Wait, I didn't read her poem. She just left. I'll be your beach. Oh, you will you? Your mind is so full of troubles and fears that diminish your wonder over the years. But today I have a special place, a beach for us to go. A shore reaching beyond your sight, a sea that sparkles with brilliant light. The walls in your mind will melt away before the sunny glow. I'll be the beach that washes your worries away. I'll be the beach that you daydream about each day. I'll be the beach that makes your heart leap in a way you thought you'd left long ago. Let's bury your heavy thoughts in a pile of sand. Bathe in sunbeams and hold my hand. Wash your insecurities in the salty sea and let me see you shine. Let's leave your memories in a footprint trail. Set you free in my windy sail. And remember the reasons you're wonderful when you press your lips to mine. I'll be the beach that washes your worries away. I'll be the beach that you daydream about each day. I'll be the beach that makes your heart leap in a way you thought had left you long ago. But if you let me by your side, your own beach, your own escape, you'll learn to love yourself again. Now we talk to Monica. Her books aren't a total escape. Okay. Ooh, okay, this is a short one for her. The Lady Who Knows Everything. An old tale tells of a lady who wanders Earth. The lady who knows everything. A beautiful lady who has found every answer. All meaning, all purpose, and all that was ever sought. And here I am, a feather. Lost adrift the sky, victim of the currents of the wind. Day after day I search. I search with little hope, knowing legends don't exist. But when all else has failed me, when all others have turned away, the legend is all that remains. The last dim star glimmering in the twilight sky. Until one day the wind ceases to blow, I fall. And I fall and fall, and fall even more. Gentle as a feather, a dry quill, expressionless. But a hand catches me between the thumb and forefinger, the hand of a beautiful lady. I look at her eyes and find no end to her gaze. The lady who knows everything knows what I am thinking. Before I can speak, she responds in a hollow voice. I have found every answer, all of which amounts to nothing. There is no meaning, there is no purpose. And we seek only the impossible. I am not your legend. Your legend does not exist. And with a breath, she blows me back aloft, afloat. And I pick up the gust of wind. Okay. What? Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Natsuki will be making cupcakes. Oh shit, cupcakes. The one who is truly useful, yeah. There is no hole kink. That's how you get voted off. We'll spend it with Yori. The house? Ooh. Is it anywhere on the first floor? And assume she's up in her room. Thank you. Mm-hmm. I'll be right back. I have to go do something. Mm-hmm. All right. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. I would feel like you're doing some sort of summoning ritual. I'll definitely be weirded out a little bit. You're kind of into that. Of course you are, Yuri. Of course you are. Yes, I would. Kinky. You read that right. That's exactly what happened. Listen, you know what they say about the quiet girls. They are into the freakiest shit. I guess that actually explains my type. You take Yuri's hand and lick her index finger in return. Ah. Yeah, you should have expected this one. Yeah, relatable. Thank you. Mm-hmm. You'd like to create a banner, okay. Yeri, when I come back, you better still have your clothes on. I will not get banned for you today. Okay, good. She has her clothes on still. Oh, hello, honey. Thank you for the 100 bits. It is greatly appreciated. Now drop and give you 1,000. No. Wait, and then you, okay. Okay, now we're stepping away. Now she's in wet clothes. Again, I really hope when we go back into the room she has her clothes on. Because again, I will not get banned for her. Unless I do. She's holding her wrist, eh? Dear Game Zach, please stop being like real Zach. Why are you like
oh,
this?
Oh, mommy.
No scary hand holding yet. Currently, we are still not living in sin. Or we can go out somewhere. Ooh. We only wrist hold here. Ah, yes. She held onto our wrist. Very sensual. Wait. Shh. She squeezed our hand. Guys, we're almost to hand-holding. We're almost to hand-holding. Wait. Sayori, why are you blue-balling me right now? We were just blue-balled. Sayori knew what she was doing. She's a smart girl. She knows what she's doing. Because you... Is it because, Sayori, you are in love with Game Zack? No, Sayori's been a childhood friend. Sayori we have known forever. It's all good. Okay, yeah, so Sayori, you are in love with the protagonist. I feel like with how we've been playing this game and how we've been usually going, the bottom option is the correct option for how we've been playing this game. However, my mind is also going to the dark place, but we're going to stick with the answer that we already have. We're not leading someone on here. They will be our closest dearest friend. I'm going to save real quick. I'm going to save right here. And I'm going to load this game because I want to see what happens if we do the other option real quick. So let's see. I want to see what happens here. Yep. Thank you. Because that's not how depression works, Sayori. Alright, so we're going to go back to this option. Just because we're going to stick with how we were playing initially. Also, they're high schoolers. They don't really say the smartest of things. By the way, there is no in-game sound right now. No, you don't know what's best for her. This gave me very much dread. Thank you. I'm not surprised at all. End. Okay, so now we're gonna go back to this part.
Oh. You can't go back. Oh, shit. Hold up. The fuck is happening?